It's time for today's race at the Autódromo José Carlos Pache circuit here in Sao Paulo. And as any of the 80,000 capacity crowd will tell you, this is going to be a fantastic race. Interlagos, always a very special race here in Brazil. It's a 2.7-mile circuit with 9 lefts and 6 rights for a total of 15 corners. The fastest lap today should have an average speed of around 135 miles per hour, if, of course, the weather stays dry until the end of the Grand Prix. Anthony Davison joins me today and looking very chirpy as well, it must be said. And by your smile, I'm guessing you're anticipating a good race today.
I always get like this when it comes to race day, Crofty. You should know that. I do think we're in for an extra exciting one today, though, that's for sure. The current lineup of drivers are all super competitive, and with the recent upgrades being made by some of the teams, who knows how today will play out.
It's time to see how our drivers are stacking up after yesterday's exciting qualifying session. An immense lap from Lewis Hamilton yesterday puts him on pole position, edging out Max Verstappen, who'll start from P2. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Leclerc, Vettel, Alexander Albon, and Bottas, Hülkenberg, Grosjean, Stroll, and Lando Norris, Gasly, Kvyat, Carlos Sainz, and Raikkonen, Perez, Giovinazzi, Kevin Magnussen, and Daniel Ricciardo. Kubica and George Russell ends our grid lineup. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track.
Okay, the run into turn one isn't too long, so the pack will be bunched up. Take care. Start. The fastest lap of the race. Keep this up. Okay, we need some energy harvesting. Reduce ERS deployment. The car behind is dropping back by about 0.3 a lap. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. Confirmed. we expect the grip levels to start falling away soon. The teammate behind is 12.5 seconds. Approaching the pit window, you'll be on the hards.
Thank you.
box, box. We're coming in this lap. Pit in this lap, and remember the speed limit. We'll be penalised if we exceed it. Keep that in mind as you approach. Exit now. That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. Advise moving to mix 2, fuel to mix 2. Battery charge is low. If we turn down the ERS deployment, we can harvest more energy.
Alexander is coming in for his stop. Increase ERS deployment. It's time to use some of this charge. At the moment, the car behind us is lapping faster than us by around 1 second per lap. You're in the top 10 now. Keep it up.
behind has started to drop back. There's a gap beginning to form. Battery is low on energy. Reduce ERS deployment. The car behind is dropping back by about 0.3 a lap.
We're leading our teammate by 27.5 seconds. we have 5 laps of fuel remaining.
Is gaining on you by 5/10 a lap. There's 3 laps of fuel remaining. Caution, caution. Some information on Norris. They're retiring from the race. Okay, clear. This is your final lap of the race. Great drive. We did it. Good job.
It was a magnificent race and a drive right out of the top draw to take the win for Red Bull today. Anthony Davidson, how do you think they were able to set themselves apart today?
I'd say it was down once again to good, consistent driving, nailing the corners, working to the track conditions and perfecting the team's strategies. They got all of these things right today and the results speak for themselves.
Red Bull are our winners today after showcasing some incredible driving. There's been a huge push from them lately to stay competitive with the other teams, and they're certainly proving themselves. Now, let's discuss, Ants. Who would you say is a contender for driver of the day?
Well, there's a lot of incredible driving out there today, Crofty, but if I had to pick someone, it's got to be Sergio Perez. Fantastic driving.
Well, Ants, an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.